Oh, we're live already? Whoa. MHK, you know, usually streamers don't take us live until the actual time of the match. But, you know... Yeah, but, like, we expect it to happen at the time of...
Alright, can someone add Mr. Shadow?
Yes.
Cool. I will be leaving you. And
yeah.
I'm really sorry, but nothing's...
Oh, no. No worries. For those of you that are tuning in, it does appear that Boncho is having some service outages in certain regions, unfortunately. And Jugs, who was supposed to join me, Zachman III, in commentating this match, is not currently available because of said outages, unfortunately.
What a fucking debut for me.
absolutely. There's absolutely nothing wrong. It is completely understandable.
Alright, well, in that case, I will be leaving you, and taking over from me will be Mr. Shadow.
Hello.
Yeah, so as we hit a slightly rough start here, unfortunately, Boncho is being Boncho as Boncho always is.
Anyway, but I'm here. What is going on?
We have just started. I don't even think we've gotten into our first warm-up between TakoJoe and Heam, a match that is sure to be promising.
Give me one moment to prepare myself. I was not quite expecting to be called up, but I've arrived to do my best.
Yeah, no worries. Absolutely no worries. This will be just a bit of a rough start here, but getting into our first warm-up, my tournament client has decided to not register itself, it appears.
Everything is going well.
But this will be Heam's warm up here. Finishing off the first warm-up, TakoJoe is going to be taking that by a large lead. Unfortunately, just... It's always sad to see whenever tournament matches get blown over because of Boncho.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, but you know, it's something you just gotta deal with.
We're gonna have just a rough start here. Hopefully it will all be cleared up by the end of the warm-ups, because I'm sure both of these players have cared quite a bit to be in this match here. Thank you. But going into our second warm-up here, this will be TakoJoe's warm-up.
Looks like he's playing hidden for this warm-up, which is an interesting choice.
Well, it certainly does ensure that it's definitely their warm-up.
Yeah. This could, depending on his performance here, this could, you know, could give Heam some insights into his bands and picks. Maybe we'll see some TakoJoe hidden later on in that.
Alright, as I finally settle in, this is what you get when you wake up late. I don't need this. I don't need this. I don't need this. Alright, let's look at some user profiles.
Yes, that would be a good idea.
As I have clearly prepared for this.
Well, regardless of profiles, TakoJoe seems to be very comfortable with his hidden skill.
I'm starting off with Heam because for some reason I always do everything in alphabetical order whether I try to or not. Rank probably about 6.3k with 491 hours of playtime, not necessarily on Taiko, but taking the beatmap spotlights of Winter 2021, the Copper 2 badge is no small feat. As I miss their top plays? Yes, I did. Their top play being a Mizutama, Hiroke's Oni diff play worth 185 PP. You're looking at predominantly no mod scores for their top plays. But on the other hand, as I try to very quickly finish this up before rolls start, TakoJoe just about 3.8k. An overall accuracy slightly ahead of Heam's at 98.17%. Their top play is going to be can't pronounce that because it's not going to translate for me, but it's worth 255 PP, a definite step up. And their third best play being a more one night play.
But yeah, rolls have been done. Heam rolls 55, TakoJoe beats him just ever so slightly with 60. And Heam's banned no mod 4.
Come on, 4. An interesting band, to say the very least.
And now TakoJoe's ban and pick, and he's banning DT2.
It's gonna be double time 2. It's gonna be 7 bye bye, which I can completely understand. Definitely not fun as a double time.
Yeah.
But what as I have to hit? Yeah, as I have to refer to the one time. Actually, was that a double time 1 ban or a double time 2?
No, he appears to have mistyped. I believe it is he did mistype DT2, he meant DT1. And he's gonna
but our
hidden
first
one.
Pick is gonna be hidden one, which is actually more one night. As I just mentioned, that being not specifically this difficulty, but Roger's Inner Oni being TakoJoe's third top play, worth 239 PP.
Now, this is also a banger.
Surprisingly, after looking at both players' top plays, decidedly no mod. Except TakoJoe apparently likes to play with Sudden Death on. That's not something that you usually see.
Sudden Death?
Yeah, wow. Sudden Death.
I'm getting flashbacks to yesterday's night.
But nevertheless, we are going to get into our first pick. I can't quite tell if this is client being stupid on he missing the first few notes or if that was actually real.
I think it was client, at least on mine. He appears to have dropped a fair few 100s, but no misses so far from either player.
Hmm.
Show, but like with one third of the map left, this is not a long map, it's only barely a minute.
Yeah, TakoJoe is gonna definitely take the lead, but finding a miss.
Ooh. But is there enough song for Heam to pull it back? The score is
it'll be closed,
but TakoJoe
there
might
is not
it with the Ak. Yeah, thank goodness he had Ak advantage. Had Heam. If Heam hadn't had a higher accuracy, that could have been somewhat troubling, but...
TakoJoe getting 4 100s, 4 misses, a perfect 98% accuracy.
Sheesh. Very well done. Well done to Heam for the full combo as well, but TakoJoe, the accuracy coming in clutch for that first point of his. And now we move on to Heam's pick. We'll see what he
As long as Heam can kind of just brush this off and say, you know what, that wasn't my pick, and whatever I do pick, I'm gonna do better on. You can definitely pull back from this.
By no means is that a. In fact, I'd almost be more concerned. If, like, for TakoJoe in that boot, in his boots, mentally speaking, he is, from his perspective, he will have only barely scraped by that point. He might be shaken for the upcoming match, especially one that Heam has picked. But we'll have to see if those,
But we will see that double time, too. It's gonna be the immediate clapback just because of ban.
Yeah, it's not always a poor decision. Although, who knows, maybe he's being baited, but...
There is always that possibility.
I know...
Personally...
I was talking with Youngin, who played in the match earlier today, and he was actually bigging up how much he hated a map in hopes that they would pick it. And he would destroy them. Unfortunately, they instead banned it because they saw right through his lies.
Ha!
But yeah. And TakoJoe. Well, apparently, he sucks at DT. Or at least it's his weakest mod. I won't say he sucks because he's probably better than I am.
Yeah. And like, being good at double time is a skill not many have.
Nah. I mean, I've played a bit of double time, but it's just. Barely passing Futsu's, which is kind of cringe.
But we will go ahead and get into this map.
Another even shorter map, not even a minute. So any mistakes here are going to be very problematic, and Heam's going to take an early accuracy advantage,
but it's not going to be very strong. Definitely the double time accuracy is going to shine through. Heam finding that first miss, but may still be able to clutch it with accuracy.
Yeah, the map's not that long.
Yeah, there's not much of a combo advantage to be gained here, and Heam does not look troubled score-wise.
Another miss could be problematic, perhaps. But at this point, it's hard to say. The score is
The score is getting so close. It's right now you're literally seeing accuracy versus combo on Scorvy 2.
Which is gonna win, Scorvy 1 or Scorvy 2, and as it draws to a close, it looks like Scorvy 2 just barely just gonna pip out TakoJoe to take the slight accuracy win.
I'm going to repeat Ark in the chat. There is no sweep. We have no one sweep. Point for both players, no and despite the quite large rank difference, there is much to be said for the fact that both players can take at least one pick of their own.
True.
Whether that continues to be the case, that does remain to be seen, but it is heartwarming to know that we will not be seeing a full sweep.
TakoJoe with the sportsmanship in there. Congratulating Heam on his accuracy and his point. You'll have to see. You'll see a good bit of friendliness between two competitors. TakoJoe's gonna come back with a Nomod 2.
With a Nomod 2?
It's tequila. I did not look at the map pool.
You'd better enjoy this, because this is one of those that's gonna be clapped in the YouTube VOD.
Yep.
Actually, it's not that bad. It'll probably stay in, but...
we'll have to see. Only the gods will decide.
This is definitely going to be your stamina pick. This map is no short map.
Casters keep screaming throughout the match, it won't get cut then. That's a good shout. If we just periodically say, like, Audio Jungle and sing the song, we'll be fine.
This one isn't that close. It won't get monetized, but it won't get taken down either.
Oh, you know, that's ideal, I guess. But yeah. Underway with the Nomod 2. This was Taco's pick, wasn't it?
I do believe.
Ooh, yeah, it went Taco Heam, so this one's Taco.
Yep.
Early on, Heam dropping a few 100s, though. This is a longer map at just shy of 3 minutes, so yeah, he's already built the accuracy back up.
I know, here I am clicking on the wrong map pool sheet. This is what happens when the season's about to change.
Well said, MHK. Well said, Malau.
Yep.
Well said, Malau. Tequila.
Heam is definitely going to have the accuracy drop at the beginning. I do believe you remember the one curse that I cannot give players.
True, I do remember. However, I'm not afraid. TakoJoe currently holding the SS.
Heam finding the miss.
The anti-curse.
The anti-curse. You do hate to see it.
That is going to be ever so slightly problematic for Heam, as Taco is approaching the 400 combo mark and still holding the SS at about halfway through the song. Very impressive performance thus far from TakoJoe.
To finally dropping the first 100, but
now Zach
very well showing off their consistency. I will curse players on everything else, but I will not double S curse them. Finding yet another miss. Heam is not looking good in this situation. But again, it does still come back to psychologically looking at this. You know, if you can say, again, not my pick, not my best map, and be able to recover and bounce back, you're doing just fine.
And yeah, Heam does drop another miss. I think that's pretty much going to seal the deal at this point. Even if TakoJoe picks up a couple misses here, he'll still have better accuracy, and I don't see that score lead being overcome. So yeah, I think TakoJoe's going to take his second point.
But as long as this doesn't beat Heam too much up, you know, clearly not very comfortably finding some combo here. But as long as they can come back for that next map, all is still well. Though I must say that 2-100 play from TakoJoe is going to be very impressive.
That is an incredibly impressive play.
Coming in at an unstable rate of 114.24.
And that's not overstated. An 830k score from Heam, 14 minutes, 95 ack. It's nothing to be like ashamed of. Solid score.
I find it hilarious that Heam has 41 100s and then 14 misses, which are the reverse of each other.
The symmetry. Beautiful.
And for those math nerds out there, 256 combo is pretty nice as well.
Size and dropping out of maths because it was awful. But I digress. And now we move back on to Heam's pick. They seem to be quite happy to go back and forth thus far.
Yeah, Hard Rock 2 is going to be the next pick. Which I feel I do not have the capacity to properly name the title. Because I know I'm going to do it wrong.
Oh my god, is that Ryu? Ryu, it's great, it's Ryu. It's Ryu from the acclaimed game Super Mario Bros. I don't know, it's sort of a fighting game, I can't see. Isn't it Street Fighter? I can't remember what game Ryu's from, I know he's from a game, but anyway. This is Ryu featuring Mai.
Alright, that's Mr. Shadow 818, everybody.
There we go, it's me. I'm here.
Heam finding that early accuracy drop, but nothing that can't be still recovered.
Yeah, as a 2-minute map, you know, it's not incredibly long, but there's still time to bring it back. Although, this would be Heam's pick.
This would be Heam's pick, so this would be a breakpoint if Heam cannot stay consistent
perhaps
here.
That's a little distressing this early on. That he's behind, but hopefully he can bring it back. Yeah, TakoJoe having dropped the SS, but still.
Heam finding the actual drop.
Ooh, now that is concerning. Halfway through the map, TakoJoe's lead is just increasing. And this could be troublesome for Heam.
LK going ding dong dan. Not quite the right map there.
Props for trying. Oh, Heam dropping again.
Heam finding another get. Yeah, it does look like we are going to see our first breakpoint.
Perhaps nerves getting the better of Heam at this point. Might be a little shaky now. That's a third point for TakoJoe and the first break point of the match. It's going to be interesting to see how Heam goes back for this one.
A 5-100 play with a 107.99 UR. Can't quite get closer to 108. But Fremont 3 is going to be played.
This is the disadvantage you still play on a notebook. Oh wait, that's a laptop. I was really confused. I'm like, what?
No, there's casually people that just play Osu Taiko on, you know, the little
paper and
like
pen.
Yeah, paper and pencil and like a spiral binding, you know?
There was a viral video, like there was a pretty popular video of like somebody playing Osu with like pennies, wasn't there?
Yeah.
It was like 5 seconds long. Oh well. Yeah, 3 months. This is gonna be interesting. This is Taco's
TakoJoe playing on a TV? As the monitor. Okay, I was like, how exactly are you playing using a TV?
He's got his Sky remote. D&D.
But this is most definitely going to be our anti-mod of the pick. Jakusha no Sengen. It'll be interesting to see which mods both players find comfortable here.
Yeah. Ooh.
Both opting for hidden.
This is an interesting choice, given that in the earlier hidden pick, TakoJoe took it quite comfortably.
Though, I can completely understand, if you're not comfortable with Hard Rock, these slider velocities are nothing to scoff at. And but Heam finding an early mid.
If this early performance is anything to go by, that as well as the last hidden pick, it looks like Heam's not going to have too much fun with this pick. Already a fairly solid score lead built up by TakoJoe, whose name is very irritating. Why can it not be TakoJoe? Heam's accuracy, never mind.
Heam finding another miss. Unfortunately, just not looking too comfortable. But
yeah, halfway through.
This may most definitely still be more comfortable than playing this with Hard Rock.
This map is also very short. We're already in the last third.
Yeah, unfortunately, just not much to say here. A very clear victory for TakoJoe here.
Yeah. Well, not a horrible performance by Heam. Again, he scores a very solid 800k points, but TakoJoe is simply just more comfortable with hidden. And that's going to take it to 4-1. Tako. And it's Heam's pick again.
So as Nomad 1 is picked, a really fun map, I would like to take the time now to mention, because I know that I don't want to do this in the middle of a map, it's going to be a very momentous occasion here at the Taiko Coliseum. We are going to see, you can call this my personal phrase because I'm sticking two words together that no one else has. It's going to be the Virgin Voyage of the B Channel. We are going to be seeing the very first match on the Taiko Coliseum B Channel being Yongin versus XYZK7777 on the level 3 pool. Which Mr. Shadow 818 was planned to originally cast before having to step in here for Jugs. I'm sure they will sort it out staff-wise. But it is very busy, to say the least, here in the Taiko Coliseum.
Yeah.
Two streams, in addition to a map pool showcase currently being filmed for the next season. Practically a total of 11 people in voice chat right now.
Dang.
Which is a momentous occasion. But as the B channel does go live, feel free to go give it a warm welcome into the Twitch world of the internet. but despite all of the excitement, we are still here with this match coming into our Nomad 1 Shattered Dreams. Definitely one that's going to emphasize consistency and accuracy. Not as much stamina. That was more Nomad 2.
I may say, these maps are very short. Most of them being under, like, 1.5
minutes. Under 2 minutes, yeah.
Yeah,
the average map time of this pool is very short. But currently tied on accuracy, the only difference is going to be one finisher at the moment.
Yeah, very close, but that is what consistency is about.
This is the map that you were definitely hoping for. MHK making the wise conclusion that yeah, this was from IGTS 2018 group stage. The majority of these picks were pulled from, and that may factor into the shortness of the maps.
Yeah, we're approaching the last sort of third of the map. Both players holding very solidly.
Yeah, the accuracy are still tied.
Oh, they were, then they dropped from Heam. He's gonna put it slightly in TakoJoe's favor. This is gonna be close.
This is one of those maps where I really wish there was a break near the end to really get those nerves into high gear. Unfortunately, without being able to see their scores, Heam's not gonna hold quite as consistent, and it's just barely gonna be taken by TakoJoe here.
100 to 2, 3 to 5. That's a 2-100 difference in that score.
Unfortunately, yeah. Being breakpoint, match point, and next pick, all to TakoJoe.
Oh, TakoJoe with literally every advantage he would need to close this out.
What the? It's going to be Freemod 2 that gets picked. Mushroom Mother, the definite anti-hidden, if I had to say. Actually, I don't know. This is probably an anti-hard rock.
I was going to say, if it was an anti-hidden, that would be an odd choice for TakoJoe, seeing as he knows Heam's not comfortable on hidden.
No, I forgot Spaceman was in this pool. Spaceman's definitely going to be the anti... No, I mean... I mean, it really just depends on what mod you find more comfortable for those. You can play both with Hidden and both with Hard Rock. But looking at my tournament client, you know, it has all of the matches of the same tournament. And I just look down and I see the map name of one of the warm-ups. I don't know what's going on over there in that other stream, but it's certainly something.
What the... Okay. I'm not... Okay. They banned dual casting, so, I mean, if you want to know, go and watch, and... Oh.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, TakoJoe going with...
TakoJoe is going to take Hidden Hard Rock, with Heam just taking Hidden.
Looking to close this out in style.
Very clearly. I really hope that this does become a match between accuracy and mod advantage, because that's what it's looking like at the moment. As with all of the maps in this pool, not very long, so there's not a lot of time to recover, but there's also not a lot of combo advantage to be gained.
Aye, just shy of 2 minutes. And they're already They're already one quarter of the way through, approaching a third.
Yeah. The most prominent feature about this map is how not dense it is.
Yeah.
There are not a lot of notes here. Just barely gonna cross, I think, the 400 combo threshold, but
ooh.
Heam's gonna find that first miss.
That
very unfortunately.
Halfway, that's gonna put all the advantages for this map into TakoJoe's favor, who now has mod, accuracy, and combo advantage.
And score advantage.
And score lead. So yeah, Heam's gonna need something good to happen. in these and a drop of water. Oh, that could very much seal the deal. The score gap is just growing, ever increasingly. Even if TakoJoe were to miss now, I do not think Heam could pull it back. Yeah, unfortunately, I think TakoJoe has closed this match out in style with the double mod to take the victory.
Yeah.
So yeah.
6-1. Ooh. Absolutely amazing.
Although it seems like it was a fairly dominant match, many of those maps were quite close. Often, I mean,
they were very close.
Yeah.
All I can say is at the very least, we did not see a full sweep.
No, we did not. But yeah, and that's
absolutely very well done.
And that's going to be GG's
now,
for the players.
Now, one of the very amazing things that we do get to have, now that we have two different channels, we get to see a tiebreaker showcase. Ooh. Because we are not pressured for time for the next match.
Indeed. Of course, this is only if the players want to. We'll have to wait and
but
see.
But it does look like we are going to see one. Both players opting in.
Oh, not that button. I nearly joined a different VC, which would have been a problem.
Yeah.
I feel as though this match could have very easily gone to tiebreaker. A few 100s or misses either way would have. I feel like this.
Yeah, it's one of those matchups that on paper looks like it would be a blowout, and yes, it did end up being more of a blowout than you'd expect. But it's also very, very likely that it could have come to a tiebreaker like this. Definitely after seeing a few of the pools of the next season, I'm very intrigued to see if they will match up again. Honestly, after seeing some of the map pools of the next season, I'm just pogged for anything. But a quick shout out to KB. I do believe this is the first bit donation of the channel.
Oh.
I know we have seen subscriptions. I have not seen bits before. It may not be exactly the first time, but 100 bits going to not a sweep. Definitely approve.
Now Taiko Mom can pay child support.
TakoJoe is going to go hidden on the tiebreaker showcase.
Ooh, very interesting.
This is a bold move.
Although he doesn't stand to lose anything from being a bit risky.
This is true. We will only be able to see in time whether this was worth it. Personally, I would probably slap Hard Rock on this, but I'm well out of the range for level 2. Unfortunately, Heam finding some misses here.
Yeah.
Actually, again, I mean, this is not quite going to get taken out of the VOD. It won't get monetized, but it won't get taken either.
Yeah, looks like Tucker's still holding.
Fairly consistently, despite the 100 drop near the beginning. Heam, unfortunately, cannot be said the same for. It will be muted on Twitch if you don't catch it fast enough, but it will not be muted on YouTube, no. You'd be surprised what's allowed by YouTube standards.
I was gonna make a Logan Paul joke there, but I thought it would be in poor taste. Although, having said the joke makes itself. Anyway, moving on.
I guess we can just chalk it up and say that it was the call of destiny. Proper response. Now, continuing on. I said it was proper response. For those of you that did not see, Mr. Shadow just dipped out of voice chat.
That was the worst thing I've ever heard. My soul is crushed. I don't know if I can recover from that.
I'm sorry. You went too far that I couldn't not reach farther.
Fair, understandable. A man of culture, I see.
I would not make such a far reach under normal circumstances, but when you mention Logan Paul, unfortunately, normal circumstances are no longer applicable.
As soon as I hear the first name, it's over. The gloves are down. It's about to be a fight.
But speaking of a fight, it's not looking like much of one here. Heam just not able to keep up combo-wise. Still displaying a very nice score, but just not living up to TakoJoe over here with the 99% accuracy, still running on FC, with
on the
hidden
as well. Somebody likes the hidden mod. Yeah,
so back to Twitch chat. They've implemented a new feature where it starts checking your video if it goes over an hour before it's even done, which absolutely it's a new feature. It was not implemented when we decided to start the YouTube channel, but it's unfortunate that some things will not be recoverable.
TakoJoe has achieved the Poggers 1k combo, and it looks to be finishing
a little
out
bit
this match.
Yeah, the nerves are definitely coming to TakoJoe, finding a few 100s near this ending, but all in all, well above a million score, meaning that the hidden was most definitely worth it. Finding only 19 100s throughout the entire map, which is, incidentally, the number of misses from Heam.
Yeah. Crazy how this thing works out. But yeah,
absolutely amazing. Very well played by both players.
An amazing performance from TakoJoe. And yeah, even if this match had gone to tiebreaker, it seems that TakoJoe it was inevitable. But I believe that is going to be the end.
That's going to be it for this match. I'm going to try to keep this quick because there is another match that we're going to go raid in just a moment because it's awesome. But I would like to take the moment to mention that the next match that is not the concurrent match is actually one that I am in up against Will on the level 4 pool, which Shadow is scheduled to commentate. So it sounds like it's going to be really amazing. I'm quite concerned about actually being able to beat Will. I most definitely would not put out of the question a possible tiebreaker. But that's going to be it from us in this match between TakoJoe and Heam. I have been Zekman III, joined today by Mr. Shadow 818, and we will hopefully see you later this weekend.
Farewell.